Minister of State for Communications, Independent Charge, and Minister of State for Railways, Sri Manoj Sinhaji, Minister of State for Corporate Affairs, Law and Justice, Sri P.P. Chaudhary Ji, President, ICAI, Sri Naveen N.D. Gupta Ji, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I am happy to be among you on Chartered Accounts Day, which also marks the formal inauguration of the Platinum Jubilee celebrations of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Appropriately, we are observing the first anniversary of the implementation of the Goods and Services Tax, that is GST. This happy coincidence makes my participation in today's function is even more pertinent. ICAI is celebrating its Platinum Jubilee just as the Indian economy is set for a surge. In the next decade, probably even by the year 2025, India is expected to double the size of GDP to $5 trillion. The growth in financial and business transactions will mean more work for chartered accountants and place a greater responsibility on you. The success of ICAI as a body of professionals is a matter of pride for our country. I am told that the 3 lakh chartered accountants you represent amount to 10% of all chartered accountants in the world. This is a matter of worthy of praise. Today, Indian accounting and auditing standards are at par with global benchmarks and mandate best global reporting practices in our country. Your institution deserves credit for making this possible. This is essential for the accountancy and financial services sector to expand rapidly. The sector has been identified by the government as one of the 12 champion services sector in India. I am confident that you will take all necessary steps to ensure that the sector achieves its full potential. Ladies and gentlemen, adherence to a fair taxation system is much more than merely providing revenue to the government. It is part of the same social contract that underpins our constitution. Under this constitution, we have given ourselves certain rights but also certain responsibilities. Taxes are what we pay to get social benefits in the form of public goods and services, health and education facilities, better infrastructure, law and order, and secure borders. It is crucial that this responsibility is shared by the widest possible number of citizens, whether they pay taxes directly or indirectly. It is the solemn duty of each one of us to contribute to the society that we share and the nation that we are part of. As chartered accountants, you have a key role in advancing such a culture. You are both facilitators of taxpayers and of the taxation system, as well as watchdogs of public trust. In many respects, a tax system is only as complicated as you want to make it. As professionals, it is your legitimate right to advise your clients on tax planning. However, there is a fine line between intelligent tax planning and tax dodging and tax evasion. Chartered accountants are custodians of that fine line. Maintaining such propriety is not just a legal duty for all taxpayers and for all taxation and financial professionals. There is also a morality added to it. When banking scandals take place, when large borrowers abscond and leave their banks in the lurch, or as in the case of Satyam, as we all know, some years ago, when promoters themselves embezzle funds and carry out fraud, it represents a breach of faith. It amounts to a betrayal of not only corporate ethics, but of honest fellow citizens and of our collective value system. White-collar crimes don't leave behind a smoking gun. They leave behind broken hearts and a shaken confidence. Vulnerable citizens, such as the poor and the middle class or the retired, could lose savings. A family's plans for a cherished occasion, such as a wedding or for a child's education, could suffer. When such episodes occur, it would be in order to introspect. It would be relevant to ask if those responsible for auditing balance sheets have truly done their duty, or if they have contributed to the sorry situation. Given this backdrop, there has been a sustained effort over the past few years to formalize the economy, enforce rule of law, promote transparency in financial and business transactions, and make India much more of a tax-compliant society. The introduction of GST has not been a stand-alone move. The opening of bank accounts under the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana for sections of our people who had hitherto not been able to access banking services, the very concept of the Jam Trinity, the push given to digital payments and non-cash transactions as part of the demonetization process, the institution of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, the passage of the Benami Transactions Prohibition Amendment Act, all of these are aimed at promoting a transparent and smooth financial system. Such a system will help citizens and corporations in conveniently paying their fair taxes. Above all, such a system will prioritize honesty. For example, if we go into the details of GST regime, we find that it has helped us achieve many goals. It has enhanced the ease of doing business by creating a common platform across the country for registration, duty payments, filing of returns, and refund of taxes. It has improved export competitiveness. It has reduced prices of many categories of goods and services and benefited consumers and end users. It has simplified procedures for small and medium entrepreneurs. GST has also enhanced reliance on technology and reduced scope for subjectivity. A massive 45,000 crore rupees of GST refunds have been made till date, entirely online and through digital banking. Above 350 crore invoices have been processed. That is roughly 1 crore invoices a day. Truly, this has been a gigantic tax reform. In the 70 years from independence to the year 2017, 66 lakh enterprises were registered with the authorities. In the 1 year of GST, another 48 lakh enterprises have been added. The enormity of that achievement and the incremental work it has generated for our tax system and our tax professionals, including many of you, has to be appreciated. In this context, I would like to congratulate all citizens and every stakeholders for the successful rollout of GST. Thank you. consumers, business persons, industrialists, those running small enterprises, government servants and tax authorities, and of course the community of chartered accountants have all played a role in this critical transition to GST. I must commend the efforts of all of you. Ladies and gentlemen, ICAI Vision 2030 clearly sets out your agenda to become the world's leading accounting body, a collective of credible professionals with competencies in accounting, assurance, taxation, finance and business advisory services. I am also happy to learn that ICAI is marking its platinum jubilee with a series of programs that committed to giving back to the society. I am told that you have undertaken to provide scholarships to meritorious children, participate in blood and organ donation initiatives, and organize GST-related skill workshops for girl students. I would particularly urge you to help promote financial literacy among our young people and especially among women. Education of women is a game changer for any country and any civilization. Greater financial literacy among women takes this process forward. It will help make us a more prosperous and a more equal society. In conclusion, I must emphasize that I am confident you will make a success of all the programs associated with your Platinum Jubilee celebrations. And of course, I am confident that ICAI and its members will keep up efforts to build a nation defined by tax transparency, tax predictability, and tax compliance. Thank you. Jai Hind.